Welcome back to Tio Today. This is Tio Pilo. This is our 90-day daily video challenge. Every single day, gagawa tayo ng videos all about personal finance, business, investments, and passive income. And ngayon, in this video, let's talk about one of the freedom assets, okay, that can provide passive income. Alright? So in the previous videos, way back on the early days, okay, we tackled about two major sources of passive income, and that is financial instruments and passive business income. So financial instruments, anything na as long as may cash ka, you're gonna invest it in that vehicle, yung cash mo tutubo yan with interest, okay? Interest. That's why in this video, one of the ways that you can earn passive income is through a vehicle called time deposits, okay? Time deposits. So of course, this is from the banks, diba? Normally, we know of time deposits from the bank. So you put your money in the bank, hindi mo siya pwedeng galawin for months or even years, okay? And they give you a slightly higher interest rate, okay? Slightly higher lang kasi yung regular savings account will give you like 0.25% interest per year, okay? Per year yan, okay? Pero yung time deposit, sometimes they can give you around like 1% interest sa bank to. Okay? So meaning, hindi mo pwedeng galawin yung pera mo in the next 1 year, okay? 2 years or 6 months. Hindi give you a slightly higher interest rate. So meaning, kapag meron kang 100,000, okay? 1% of that is, bibigyan ka ng 1,000. Okay? After 1 year, assuming 1% interest per year, passive income na yan kasi intact, oh, wala kang ginawa, meron kang 1,000 pesos in passive income. Pero medyo maliit yun, di ba? Pero the point is, that's a passive income source. Okay? So, after, aside from the banks, okay? Kasi yung banks, they have different bank products. Meron sa mga savings accounts na medyo higher yung interest rates, pero you can just withdraw like twice a month. Okay? May mga different products sila. But basically, maliit lang yung interest rates. So, aside from the banks, I want to introduce to you a vehicle that also give time deposits. And these are cooperatives, okay? Mga co-op, alright? So when you hear the word cooperatives, usually, yung what comes into our mind is utang, okay? Ayun, punta tayo sa co-op so that mangungutang tayo, okay? So personally, I've also experienced having an account in a cooperative, and I really tried it for myself, okay? I really tried it for myself. I want to experience it. And what better way to learn, diba, is to experience it. So, when it comes to cooperative naman, if mangungutang ka, let's say for example, ng 7,000, okay? You borrow money 7,000, and then they let you pay, forgot, like 6 months ata. 6 months, okay? And then after 6 months, I computed, yung total na mababayaran ko is, or nabayaran ko is 9,000. 9,000. So basically, 2,000 in interest. Okay? So when you think about it, that's 2,000 divide by 7,000. Magkano yan? Like, that's more or less 30%, diba? More or less 30% interest. Okay? Yung savings mo na sa banko, 1% lang. Nangutang ka sa co-op, 30%. Okay? So that's why a lot of people, in terms of financial education, we are not financially educated, lagi tayong napu-pull down, okay? Because of this one. However, yung kagandahan ng co-op din is ganito, since malaki yung interest nila in terms of debts, kasi majority of, here in the Philippines, majority of the income from cooperatives comes from debts, okay? Actually, sa ibang bansa, like sa US, right? Yung cooperatives nila, hindi lang debts eh. Yung, may mga products talaga sila. Meron sila mga pharmacies, meron sila mga groceries, parang ganon. Okay? Dito lang sa Pinas, kapag cooperative, we connect it with debt, di ba? Hey, cooperative, pa-member tayo, so pwede tayong mangutang. Okay? Kaya yun. Okay? So anyhow, since malaki yung kita nila in terms of collections through debt, that's why sometimes some cooperatives, they give a decent interest rates then like 5 to 6% of their savings accounts and time deposits. Okay, time deposit meaning, ilalagay mo yung pera in a cooperative, time deposit, hindi mo siya pwedeng galawin, pero you can earn 5 to 6% interest per year. Okay? So, malaki na din. Malaki na din. Alright? Pero yung risk ng cooperative, this is not insured by the banks, meaning, kapag malugi yung cooperative, lugi talaga yung pera mo. Kasi, this is how cooperatives work. Alright? So, it's a membership type. That's why it's called cooperative because it requires cooperation. So, let's say for example, 10K, 10K, and then this one is 20K. They pool their money, okay? And then meron pang mga ibang gusto magpa-member, like they have like a million dito. So, itong 1 million, each of these members, they have what you call shares. Alright? That's why they call it share capital. Okay? Yung share capital, hindi mo siya pwedeng kunin. Hindi mo siya pwedeng kunin unless you revoke your membership. Okay? So, hindi siya is risk because hindi siya regulated ng banks. It's not protected with PDIC. So, kapag malulugi talaga yung cooperative, okay? Lugi talaga. Yung pera mo, mawawala na talaga. Okay? Pero, anong tawag nito? Kasi the only risk that these cooperatives can go bankrupt if itong mga members na to na nangutang, okay, hindi magbabayad. Okay? Pag hindi sila magbabayad. Kasi majority of the products of cooperatives, debts. Okay? But then again, guys, I wanna do a quick disclaimer lang pala. I forgot, when it comes to investments, talaga disclaimer. Disclaimer, okay? This is for informational purposes only. This is not a financial advice. I just wanna share the lessons that you're learning with the best of my knowledge. I'm sharing it to you for educational purposes only. Okay, very important disclaimer. Kasi baka you're sisihin nyo, ako nag-invest ako ng cooperative dahil kay Tio Pilo. So wag ha, wag. This is just for informational purposes only so that you have an idea ano yung mga different vehicles that you can venture. Okay? So yun, the only way that a cooperative can go down is kapag hindi magbabayad itong mga members na to. Okay? Kasi majority of the products of cooperatives are into debt. Alright? Kaya, if you're gonna ask me, ano yung magandang cooperative? Maganda yung cooperative that they have different other sources. Kapag meron silang other sources of income. There are cooperatives na meron silang mga grocery. Okay? Grocery. Medyo expensive yung grocery nila. Ayatan sila. Okay? And then, ayun. I'm not sure if dito sa Philippines meron nata pharmacy yung iba. Okay? So, mga different sources ng yung cooperative aside from debt, aside from utang. And another way na maganda na cooperative is ito, company. If yung company nyo may cooperative, again, yung company nyo may cooperative, maganda din siya. Bakit? Yung mga members ng cooperative are employees. Okay? Are employees, meaning, kapag itong employee na to hindi magbabayad sa utang niya sa company cooperative, okay? Salary deduction yan eh. So you are assured, salary deduction, so you are assured na, ano tawag nito? Yung mga utang, okay? Yung source of income ng co-op, mababayaran talaga. Kasi salary deduction yan sa mga empleyado. Okay? But again, it's still a risk. May risk pa rin, pero at least this one is safer because you are assured that the members are just employees, are also employees of the company, and anytime, salary deduction. Kapag the employee naman is, they're gonna resign, okay? Tapos may utang pa siya, of course, ima-minus yun sa final pay, di ba? So parang ganyan. And then, ayun, let's talk about the interest rate. How do you make passive income with cooperative and their time deposits? So let's say, assuming natin yung time deposit ng cooperative is 5% interest per year. Here's a strategy. Okay, here's a strategy. See, for example, on January, okay, January 2019, after 1 year, January 2020, magmamature na yung time deposit mo. See, for example, you put here 400K. Assuming may pera, okay? Mayroon kang 400K, at the end of 1 year, dito, manganganak yan ng 20K. Okay? 20K. On the February naman, maglalagay ka na naman ng 400K. On February 2020, again, another 20K. Okay? January, February, March, April, and so forth, December. So meaning, maglalagay ka ng 400K per month. Okay? And then, every year, alright, you're gonna receive yung interest na 5%. 20K per month. Okay? So, ito, intact na to. Intact na to. Yung gagawin mo lang, i-roll over. I think roll over ata yung term nun. Meaning, i-re-renew mo yung time deposit mo. Okay? I-re-renew mo siya. So, ito intact every single month. Okay? After 1 year, you're gonna collect only the interest rates. Alright? So, hindi ko pa ito na-achieve, ha? Pero, yan din yung isang goal ko. The problem with this one, kapag i-add mo lahat yan, this would equivalent to 4.8 million ata. 4.8 million pesos. If meron 4.8 million, pwede ganito yung strategy mo. And you can diversify. This one is co-op 1, ito co-op 2, ito cooperative 3. Okay? Para kapag malugi itong isang co-op, meron ka pang ibang cooperatives. Okay? Kasi, another strategy would be, yung 4.8 million mo, lagay mo lahat in a cooperative. So, after one year, at 5%, meron kang like 240,000 in interest alone. Divide mo yan by 12 months, meron kang 20K per month. The problem with that is, what if pag-receive mo ng 240,000 interest mo, gagastusin mo lahat? Wala ka ng passive income next following months, di ba? Kaya magandang strategy din to. Every month, you break this down into 12 months, okay? And then, lagay mo siya. Every year, magmamature, kukunin mo yung interest, and so on and so forth. Okay? Yung 12 minutes na pala. Okay? So, basically, this is one of the strategies that you can achieve. Passive income, lifestyle income, using a vehicle called time deposit in the banks. Pero yun yan, maliit na lang yung bank eh. You can venture into cooperative. Again, disclaimer, okay, this is for informational purposes. It's a strategy that you could also try out. Alright, so once again, this is Theo Pillow. And if you find this helpful, visit freedomlovephdotcom and I look forward to seeing you inside. Bye-bye, thanks for watching.